Several groups mark the 50th anniversary of the martial law declaration. This as families of martial law victims urge Filipinos to reject attempts to revise what transpired during one of the country's darkest periods. Bianca Dava reports.
Through his writing and storytelling, Joey Faustino is able to keep the memory of his brother alive. Jerry, Joey's only brother, was only 21 years old and a graduating student from the University of the Philippines, Los Baños, when he was abducted in 1977.
UPLB, he was active with the Student Catholic Action. That was an organization of students at the time. Apparently, dumating na lang yung araw na hindi na siya nakabalik sa amin dahil sa Los Baños siya at kami ay nakatira in Quezon City. So he would go home weekly.
The discovery of Jerry's ransacked dorm room in Laguna led to his family's frantic search for him. It was then when they learned that 9 other teachers and students from the university were also abducted. They were later called the Southern Tagalog 10, the single biggest case of involuntary disappearance during martial law. The search brought Jerry's family and the families of other missing individuals to 2 mass graves in Mauban, Quezon Province, where soldiers had buried what they describe as young rebels after being killed in a supposed encounter.
He went to Juan Ponce Enrile, who was then defense minister, because Enrile was a batchmate in UP law. My father tells me na tinanong niya, sabi niya nawawala yung aking anak. Ang sagot daw sa kanya ay aktivista yung anak mo, kaya malamang wala na yan.
But in the end, they did not find Jerry in the mass grave. In 1980, church youth leader and teacher Romeo Crismo was abducted by suspected members of the military in Tugagaraw, Cagayan. His brother Louis recalled that even at a young age, Romeo was heavily involved in social change movements and was critical of the Marcos dictatorship.
Involved siya sa organizing ng mga young people, conscientizing or making them aware of social issues, and urging them to take actions dun sa mga nangyayari.
Then 24-year-old Romeo was last seen by students outside their school campus before he disappeared. What followed were years of endless searching. Romeo's wife and parents visited military camps in Cagayan and Isabela every single day in the months after his disappearance. They followed information that led to nowhere. Both Jerry and Romeo's parents died without ever seeing their sons again. The Philippines has a long history of enforced disappearances, and each administration has recorded desaparecidos, usually activists and labor leaders, people regarded as political dissenters. According to data from the Families of Victims of Involuntary Disappearances, or FIND, as of June 2022, there are 2,520 reported cases since the administration of the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr. Only 2,066 of these cases are documented. Out of this number, 1,163 remain missing, 627 surfaced alive, and 276 were found dead. Of the reported cases, most were recorded during the Marcos regime with over 1,000. This is followed by the number of enforced disappearances under the administration of former President Corazon Aquino at 825. FIND saw a decline in the number of missing persons during the administrations of former Presidents Fidel Ramos and Joseph Estrada, with 80 and 64 cases respectively. But the number of victims grew to over 300 under former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo as a result of her all-out war against communist insurgents and terrorists. The group recorded 32 desaparecidos under former President Benigno Aquino III. Meanwhile, more than 140 disappearances were reported during the term of former President Rodrigo Duterte. Most of the cases were alleged to be drug-related. For 16 years, the families of victims have lobbied for a desaparecidos law. So when former President Benigno Aquino III signed into law the Anti-Enforced or Involuntary Disappearance Act of 2012, they saw a glimmer of hope in their quest for justice. Republic Act 10353 states that a crime of enforced disappearance is considered committed if a victim is deprived of liberty. The perpetrators are agents of the state or those working with the support and authorization of the state. And there is a conscious effort to conceal information on the whereabouts of the victim. However, 10 years since its passage, the landmark law has yet to achieve its full potential. No one has so far been meted life imprisonment, and cases rarely progress. The Commission on Human Rights pointed out that a lack of proper understanding of the concept of human rights hinders the proper implementation of the law. The Commission added, should the Philippines sign a United Nations International Human Rights Instrument that will prevent enforced disappearances from happening, families of victims will have another option to report their cases of involuntary disappearances, and government will be pressured to act on them. It has been over 40 years since Jerry and Romeo have disappeared, and life has been nothing but cruel for their families with the Marcoses back in power. But Joey and Louie use the pain and grief to continue calling for justice, not just for them, but for other desaparecidos and their families.
There's a great apprehension kung anong mangyayari dun sa mga files. Unang-una, nahawak ng gobyerno. Dahil nga nagpapakalat ng kasinungalingan, hindi naman sila, pero yung kampo nila, nagpapakalat ng kasinungalingan. No, there is no such human rights violations that occurred during the time of the dictatorship. But power, absolute power, corrupts itself. So I think that's self-explanatory. If you don't have checks and balances, yun yun.
Ako, magkukwento pa rin ako kasi gusto ko ang mapanatili at malaman ng mga tao, lalo na yung mga kabataan, yung ganitong mga kwento. In the face ng sitwasyon na mayroong historical distortion, binabaliwala yung kasaysayan, binabaluktot ang kasaysayan.
Although it is painful to keep on recalling the disappearance of their loved ones, Joey and Louie said it is important to keep on telling their stories to the next generation. They urged Filipinos to reject efforts to forget what happened during the country's darkest period and not to bury the memories and sacrifices of those who were killed and tortured and those who are still missing. Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News.